बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर इकॉन 103 स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर गोइंग थ्रू द इक्विलिब्रियम एनालिसिस फ्रॉम द पार्शियल मार्केट एंड फ्रॉम द इंटरनल मार्केट, एंड देयर इज अ वी हैव डन इन द क्लास पार्शियल मार्केट एंड वी आर लेफ्ट विद द स्मॉल कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ जनरल मार्केट. सो दिस वीडियो आई एम रिकॉर्डिंग इन ऑर्डर टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड that what is a general market and how do we get the equilibrium in this market and what are the meaning of coefficients and little more about this general equilibrium. So let's start with this. So if you just have a look at your book, so you can see this is general market equilibrium and these kind of equations are there. But first I would like to go with the solution of one of the question, and then I would explain the meaning of these questions. So practically the difference between this model and the previous model we have done earlier is that now we will have not only one market but more than one market. So if suppose there are two markets, two commodities whose market is given, commodity one and commodity 2. So you can take an example of like commodity 1 is, let's say, Coke, and commodity 2 is Pepsi, or you can take the Coke and Lay's, or you can have a pizza or Pepsi. So there are these two markets will definitely be connected in some way. That's why we are discussing their equilibrium together. So if we have like more than two markets, then the model is written like this. Well, first I will write a partial market in which we just talk about one market at a time. So partial market has supply, has demand, has equilibrium. So the equilibrium equation is QD1 is equals to, you know, A naught plus A1 P1, where A naught is positive and A1 is negative because of law of demand. QS1 is equals to so QS1 QS1 is equals to B naught plus B1 P1, where B naught is negative and B1 is positive because of law of supply. So that's what we have discussed earlier about, and then we have an equilibrium QD1 is equals to QS1, right? And it's being already discussed. Now we are talking about general equilibrium, and we are considering two markets. So market means supply and demand. So it is demand equation, you know, market for commodity 1 will be supply demand equilibrium, right? Isi tarah se the market for commodity 2 is supply demand and equilibrium. So basically, let's write down the equation of supply, demand and equilibrium. Let's say I have QD. Since it's a market 1, so I'll put 1 to show that this is a quantity demand for product 1. Let's say it is A naught plus A1 P1, right? And now I would insert A2 P2. What's the reason? Suppose commodity 1 is Coke and commodity 2 is Pepsi. So the Coke demand would definitely be affected by the price of Coke, but also the demand for Coke will also be affected by the price of Pepsi. So that's why this equation contains the element of price of Pepsi in it, which is reflected by A2 P2. Right? I'm now writing supply equation, which is a simple one. QS1, sorry, supply of commodity 1. It is, let's say, B0 plus B1 P1. It's very simple. And similarly, I would like to write the equilibrium QD1 is equals to QS1. right? Similarly, I would write the equations for commodity 2. I would like to go the commodities 2 equations downwards, niche. So let's first write down commodity 2 equations. So QD2 is equals to, let's say this is alpha naught plus alpha 1 P1 plus alpha 2 P2 plus 9. That's it. Then I will write the equation of QS2. Let's say it's beta naught plus beta 1 P2, right? That's a simple one. And then I will write equilibrium QD2 is equals to QS2. So what's the difference? You have the market for commodity 1 and you have the market for commodity 2. The similar supply demand equation and equilibrium equations are there. But the only difference is that now commodity 2's prices are affecting demand for product 1. And isi tarah se jo hai ye, if you look at demand for product 2, it is being affected by P1. Can you see that? So now we have to have parametric restriction, which is very important. In every demand equation, intercept has to be positive for the same reason which I mentioned in the class about the simple model. Okay. उसके बाद इफ आई टॉक अबाउट A1, नाउ A1 इज अ कनेक्शन बिटवीन क्वांटिटी डिमांड ऑफ प्रोडक्ट 1 एंड प्राइस ऑफ प्रोडक्ट 1. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू लॉ ऑफ डिमांड इट हैज टू बी नेगेटिव. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इज दैट व्हाट इज A2. नाउ A2 कैन बी positive or A2 can be negative. Agar A2 positive hai, that simply means that the price of the product 2 increases, that will result in increase in quantity demand of product 1. So that has to, it is only possible if the two product commodity 1 and commodity 2 are substitutes, right? And second is that if A2 is negative, that is a reason that when the commodities are complements. Right, so you just analyze yourself that why in complementary product A2 is negative, right? I will ask you. Now coming to this supply equation, it's just conventional supply function as we have done earlier. B0 is negative, as you know, and B1 is positive because of law of supply. The third equation is nothing but same equilibrium equation. And if we look at the commodity 2 demand function, again it contains not only P2 but it also has P1 in it. So P2 ka coefficient is nothing but law of demand, so it is negative. This is again positive, same reason as I mentioned earlier, and this could be positive or negative based upon whether the two commodities are substitute to each other or the complementary products. And if you look at the supply equation, it's just the same as we have discussed earlier, nothing new. So I'm moving on and I am trying to solve this equation. So instead of solving this way, I would like to have a model in term of numerical form, and then I will solve it. And moreover, I would request you that after understanding this model, it's always better to have a market model for three commodities where product 1 is there, product 2 and product 3. So just like we have mentioned two set of equations, now then we will have three set of equations, one for commodity 1, second for commodity 2 and third for commodity 3. So I would like you to write yourself and to have the meaning of intercept. For example, if you will write the first equation in that model, you would write QD1 is equals to A0 plus A1 P1 plus A2 P2 plus A3 P3. Now because the third market is there, supply equation will remain the same, and similarly in every models, demand equation will change to P3, and you will have not 6 equations but actually 9 equations. So I would ask you to do it yourself and to have a consultation with me in my class. So I'm moving on for the solution. So let's have a look at your model. That's your book. So here we go. I am picking up this equations. So let's pick up these equations and let's see that how we can solve it. So let me take it somewhere else, yeah, just for a moment. In order to write the equations, I am doing all this. Okay, So here we go. So now my equation is qd1 is equals to 10 minus 2p1 plus p2. qs1 is equals to minus 2 plus 3p1. And qd2 is equals to 15 plus P1 minus P2, and Qs2 is equals to minus 1 plus 2P2. Okay, so let me write it again. So QS2 is equals to, let me see the book once again, minus 1 plus 2P2. So here we go with the model. What is missing? So first equation demand and first commodity supply, but equilibrium is not there. So iska matlab hai, we will also have QD1 is equals to QS1 as a part of this model, and QD2 is equals to QS2 as a part of this model. Now first I would like to go for the analysis of this first equation. Look, the first intercept is 10, as we know that demand's intercept is positive. Now look at this minus 2P1. This is quantity demanded of product 1, and this is price of P1. The link between has to be negative because of law of demand, and so you can see minus 2 is the coefficient which is according to law of demand is to be negative. Now the link between quantity demanded of commodity 1 and price of product 2, and this link, as you can see, is described by a positive sign. What does it mean? This simply means that when P2 goes up, quantity demand of commodity 1 goes up. So if I ask you that what kind of link you can see from these equations into the product 1 and product 2, so the price co positive whenever price 2 cross effect, this is called cross effect, whenever P2 increase will increase quantity demand. That simply means that commodity 1 and commodity 2 are substitute. Okay, this is only possible in case of substitute. Okay, isi tarah se look at this second equation. This is very simple conventional supply equation for product 1, minus 2 plus 3p1, where plus 3 is actually the symbol of law of supply. Now look at second equation, qd2. Again, it is not only being affected by p2 but also p1 because of cross effect, and you can see that minus 1 p2 is just nothing but law of demand, but p1 ke sath positive sign again reinforces that commodity 1 and commodity 2 are substitute. And similarly, fourth equation is very simple, so no need to explain. And now let's go to the solution of the model. Yeah, solution is very, very simple. You just need to use this equation and this equation. So I am using this equation, qd1 is equals to qs1. So if I just insert these equations here, so what do we have? Qd1 is this part. So 10 minus 2p1 plus p2 is equals to, what is qs1? It's right here, minus 2 plus 3p1. Now simplify the equation by taking every p term on the left side and the constant terms on the right side. So what I'll have, I will bring this minus 2 in this side and I will take these terms on the other side. So I'll have 10 plus 2 on the left side, and I'm shifting to P1 will become positive, minus P2 will become negative, plus 3P1. And if I just look at it, this is 5P1 minus P2, 5P1 minus P2, and it is equal to 12. So just keep this equation on one side and call it, let's say, equation 1. Then do the same thing to the model number 2. The model number 2 is QD2 is equals to QS2. And what is QD2? It is 15 plus P1 minus P2. And what is QS2? It's over here. कहीं पे भी यहाँ पे P1 से insert कर दो, you will get Q bar 1. And इसी तरह से insert P2 over here, you will get Q bar 2. So this model will have solution like P bar 1, Q bar 1, P bar 2, Q bar 2. So that's very simple. ये आपने करना खुद ही. और I just have given you the hints, and my main objective was to make you understand the coefficients, the model, and its logic behind this model. So thank you so much, guys. We are done. So I'll do this question. I will repeat this question for you in the class, but basic modeling is being done, and I recommend you to practice this kind of model with 3 equations and try to understand the meaning of all A's, all B's, all alphas, all betas. So you can take same symbol for the coefficient for the first market, A's and B's, for the second market, alphas and betas, and for the third market, you can take gammas and deltas, and do write all the equations, try to understand the meaning of every coefficient, the laws, the theories behind, and the relationship between the commodities, right? Thank you so much.